to Good Morning Region 8. It's 65 degrees at 6:16, and it's time for a look at national news.
Yeah, and this hitting a little close to home, in fact. The search continues this morning for two girls swept away from a Missouri campsite by floods over the weekend. A family of six was camping near a creek when floodwaters covered the area. The parents and their two boys were able to make it to safety, but the girls were washed away. The Missouri Water Patrol is using a search dog and a search boat. They're hoping the girls are somewhere along the shore of the creek.
Several tornadoes have cut a path of death and destruction through southern Texas. Authorities say 32 people were killed, 30 of them in the town of Jarrell, about 40 miles north of Austin. This man describes a six-block area as pretty well flattened.
Touchdown here. This looks like to be the worst of it right here.
What was here before?
Houses, tree line, power lines, barns, rodeo arena.
Now what does it look like?
As you can see from that.
Command centers have been set up in Jarrell and Cedar Park. Widespread power outages are reported. At least six twisters touched down yesterday afternoon in a line from south of Waco, just north of Austin. Drivers took shelter under highway overpasses as the twisters appeared just off the road. A tornado also touched down in Cedar Park. The twister blew the roof off of an Alverston's grocery store, causing the building to collapse. At least eight people were injured, and one is still missing in the rubble. Another tornado descended from the clouds just outside of Waco. It destroyed a mobile home near Moody, but no one was killed. At Lake Belton, the twister destroyed a marina and at least five boats.
Makes you realize how lucky we are.
It really does.
How bad it could have been, because that same storm is the one that blew through here.
That's right.
And we can still see showers and thunderstorms popping up on our radar right now, so we're watching it very carefully for you. But our weather should be improving. It's 18 minutes after the hour. Time for weather on the 8. And our temperature is 66 degrees under mostly cloudy, rainy skies. Humidity 93%. Barometric pressure falling from 29.96, and the winds from the east at about 6 miles per hour. Here's the way it looks on Little Rock NEXRAD radar. You can see the line of storms that moved through this morning. The warnings that were issued earlier or during the overnight hours and earlier this morning expired around 3:30, but you can still see as it breaks up, there are still little isolated cells of thunder showers and thunderstorms. Nothing severe right now. We don't expect it to become severe today, but redevelopment again tonight. We're expecting thunder showers early across the entire region, but should become partly cloudy to partly sunny during the afternoon hours as that system continues to make its way eastward out of Region 8. We're expecting highs in the mid to upper 70s, even near 80 in the southern counties of Region 8 today. So we're going to watch it carefully again tonight, because as the sun pops out, destabilizes the air, and we could see some more thunder showers and thunderstorms pop up during the evening.
Okay, it's time for a look at sports. The Utah Jazz are just one victory away from their first trip to the NBA Finals.
And R.A. Lundbeck waits out 2 days of rains and delays in the second Indianapolis 500. Here's Amy Lundy with your Good Morning Sports Report.
The Utah Jazz outmuscled the Rockets to take a 3-2 series lead. Karl Malone scored 29 points and grabbed 14 boards, and Charles Barkley was held to just 10 points as the Jazz won it 96-91. After 2 days of rain delays, the Indy 500 finished with excitement and a touch of controversy. Ari Lyandike won his second Indianapolis 500 by passing teammate Scott Goodyear on the 194th lap. But 3 laps from the end of the race, Tony Stewart's bump on the wall brought on a caution. Then with 1 lap to go, the starter waved a green flag. But lights mounted on the track wall were still yellow. Lyandike saw the flag and took off. But Goodyear followed the lights and stayed back. And the rest is Indy 500 history. In baseball, Cleveland must have forgotten just how powerful Albert Bell can be. The Indians walked Chicago's Frank Thomas to get to their former teammate, and Bell made him pay with a grand slam as Chicago won it 8-2. Seattle's Ken Griffey Jr. broke his old record for most home runs in May with 23, but it was two homers by Marty Cordova that won the game for the Twins 11-10. The Tigers won their third in a row, Texas routed Toronto. The O's took care of the Yanks. Boston edged Milwaukee and opened rallied with a 5-run 10th to beat KC. The Braves beat the Padres 9-2. Kenny Lofton knocked one into the Padres bullpen where it was still in play, but nobody went after it as Lofton ended up with a 3-run inside the park home run. The Cubs got by the Pirates. Stan Javier had the game-winning hit for the Giants. Montreal rallied past the Mets. It was the Phillies over the Reds. The Marlins took care of the Dodgers, and St. Louis pitcher Alan Bennis had 3 hits, including a 2-run single for the Cards.
Listen as your day unfolds, challenge what the future holds. Try and keep your head up to the sky. You gotta be bad, you gotta be bold, you gotta be wiser. You gotta be hard, you gotta be tough, you gotta be stronger. You gotta be cool, you gotta be cool.
Good morning, America. Weekday mornings at 7, right here on your good neighbor station, KAIT.
It's time to set the record straight on resale value. In full-size pickups, there can only be one king of the hill. There is, and his name is Chevy. Chevy. The most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. Long live the king.
When we're advertising with KAIT, people from all over Northeast Arkansas and Southeast Missouri come in and say they have seen our commercials on KAIT.
Welcome back. It's 65 degrees at 6:23, and it's time to see who's celebrating a birthday today in Region 8. Today we start off with Preston DuBois of Truman. He is 6 today. Preston goes to Cedar Park Elementary. Happy birthday from your mom, dad, and Tisha. Kimberly Tucker is 7 today. Kimberly was just in the Miss Raider pageant, and she likes Diana Davis. Happy birthday from your family.
Ashley Harris is 6 today. Ashley is in kindergarten at Walnut Ridge. Happy birthday from your dad, mom, and Jennifer. Susie Knight is 43 today. Susie lives in Harrisburg. Happy birthday from your 3 sons.
A Myron man and his great-grandson share a birthday today. Grandpa Jack Cliff is 76 years young. His great-grandson Cody Cooper is 5. Cody lives in Melbourne. Happy birthday from all of your family.
William Johnson Jr. is 3 today. William lives in Jonesboro. Happy birthday from your mom and dad. Hannah Williford is 2 today. Hannah lives in Portia. Happy birthday from your parents and grandparents.
Our final birthday today is Wyatt. Wyatt Will is 2 today. Happy birthday from your mom and dad. If you'd like to have a birthday announcement on Good Morning Region 8, send a picture along with the person's name, age, and hometown to birthdays. Care of KAIT, P.O. Box 790. Jonesboro, Arkansas, 72403.
And make sure to get that in the mail 2 weeks in advance and include a self-addressed stamped envelope if you want your picture back. That was a little bit tricky. Will Wyatt will be 2 today. That's what it says. Will Wyatt will be 2 today. So, happy
birthday. I didn't get that.
It was a little confusing. All of how you read it.
I guess so.
Well, happy birthday to Will, nonetheless. We've seen some pretty strong storms across Region 8 the last couple of days, and that's how we introduced Julie to our show, with a lot of storms. But earlier this week, you may have heard us blame the bad weather on a dry line. So what's a dry line? That's the topic of today's Weather Wonder. How can a system called a dry line produce so much wet weather? Well, much like a cold front is the leading edge of cooler air, a dry line is the leading edge of drier air. And as you may know, the leading edge of a system is where the action takes place. A dry line is the boundary between the dry desert air mass of the southwest and the warm, moist air mass of the Gulf of Mexico. It usually runs north and south across the central and southern plains during the spring and summer. What happens is the dry air moving in evaporates the moist air and cools it down rapidly. This cooling causes the moisture to condense and produce heavy rainfall and storms. This also creates instability and causes downdrafts to develop. These downdrafts can reach speeds of up to 100 miles per hour. We call these microbursts, and they can do as much damage as a tornado. And keep in mind, when we have strong downdrafts, we usually have strong updrafts. And you know what that means? Conditions are right for tornadoes.
And if you have a question, here on KAIT8, P.O. Box 690, Jonesboro, Arkansas, 72403.
And we did have that dry line move through. It kind of sucked up all the moisture and cooled things down rapidly. Well, there's no longer a dry line because it's just moisture-laden air now, and that's what we have, as indicated by the high humidity. We'll take a closer look at our weather in just a moment. First, today's pet pick. And this is a picture of a cat working a puzzle. If you can look carefully there, the puzzle was almost finished, but Jagger decided he wanted to get into the puzzle box, I guess. Jeremy Poindexter of Paragould sent that picture to us. Our temperature right now is 65 degrees under mostly cloudy, rainy skies. And yeah, we do have a few thunder showers and thunderstorms across the region. Our humidity is at 93%, the barometric pressure falling from 29.96, and the winds from the east at 6 miles per hour. Temperatures around the region right now, 66 degrees at Jonesboro Airport, 64 in Batesville and in Wallen Ridge. It's 63 in Poplar Bluff, 64 in Cape